While we could focus on many watchmakers throughout history, I think it's more important to focus on a few watchmakers that had direct impact on both myself as a watchmaker and still have an impact on the watches that we wear as consumers today. We talk about famous watchmakers, we have to start with a kind of a transition from clockmakers to watchmakers. And to me, John Harrison made one of the most important inventions in the 1700s, and that was he made the first marine chronometer, which made it possible to navigate the open ocean using a clock. By doing that, he actually invented an escapement called the Grasshopper Escapement. It was a very large apparatus, looks like a grasshopper, it kind of locks in and out. But he also made marine chronometers after that with the H2 and the H3. So he made the first marine chronometers, constantly shrinking them in size. That led to an invention by Thomas Mudge, who invented the lever escapement, which is still in use today. It brought a new precision to watchmaking. The escapement actually allows the power to escape through the watch, allowing the hands to move and regulate the time. Before the lever escapement, escapements were very sloppy. They were cylinders, there were a lot of moving parts, there was high friction. When Thomas Mudge invented the lever escapement, he changed the course of watchmaking history. When we talk about famous watchmakers, you have to talk about Abraham Breguet. So many important inventions that carry his name today. You have the Breguet overcoil that's used by so many watch brands. It's the mark of precision. When you see a Breguet overcoil, you know that watch is made to a different level. It's so easy to make a flat coiled hairspring. Flat coiled hairsprings are very, very accurate, but the Breguet overcoil takes that flat coiled hairspring and puts an extra loop across the top of it, helping to keep that hairspring centered throughout the different positions. So to me, Abraham Breguet, with simple inventions, simple now, inventions as the Breguet overcoil that still carry his name to this day and is still utilized by the top watch manufacturers today is the mark of true excellence. Other inventions from Breguet were the tourbillon. The tourbillon eliminated the influence of gravity in the pocket watch. Whichever way the pocket watch was laid, that's how it would gain or lose time. He solved that problem by taking an escapement and actually making it rotate and eliminating the effects of gravity on that watch. When we turn to the early 1900s, the 20th century, we were still carrying pocket watches. Everybody carried pocket watches. That was the standard. And pocket watches in America were at a very, very high quality. The American pocket watch industry was extremely high in the early to mid 1900s. In the early 1900s, there was a bad train collision in Ohio. One of the conductor's watch had actually stopped for 5 minutes and started back up again. This led to a train collision, and Webb C. Ball, being a watchmaker in Cleveland, Ohio, saw this as a problem and initiated a set of steps to alleviate this. And he came up with the standardization for watches and watchmakers to actually, for a new precision, a new set of standards to be used on railroads, which was the primary source of travel at the time. This was adopted by all the different manufacturers because to have a railroad-grade pocket watch, it had to be adjusted to position, it had to be adjusted to temperature, it had to have an isochronism, it also had to have power reserve, and it had to have an easy display. It had to have the 12 at the top of the crown. It had to be an open-faced pocket watch. It had to have a lever set. These were some of the criteria that he put into this watch. And again, all the manufacturers adopted this. It was such a strong change in the philosophy of watchmaking and precision that Swiss watch manufacturers started adopting it as well. There was a problem. Webb C. Ball saw the problem, found a solution, and brought everybody else together to join into that. We still see that today in the precision in the adjusted positions of watches, and this is where it started, was with Webb C. Ball. The most important watchmaker of the 20th century has got to be George Daniels. He designed a new escapement, and actually the last newest escapement that has been designed in watchmaking, and that's the coaxial escapement. And as he designed that, he designed it to be, actually run without lubricant, and that was the whole basis behind that. No lubricant meant fewer services. That's not exactly how it worked out. We use lubricants on the coaxial now as more of a dampener than anything else because of the shock. It just takes the shock out of it to keep parts from wearing down. But it doesn't have the friction that the Swiss lever escapement has. Daniels, when he first started making it in the 1970s, he tried to sell it to different brands. He tried to sell it to Patek. He tried to sell it to Rolex. Nobody was interested, but he was able to offer his coaxial statement to Omega, who refined it, who keeps improving it, and Omega is really enjoying the fruits of George Daniels' labor today. George Daniels' top student is Roger W. Smith, who's producing and following directly in the line of George Daniels today, working with a lot of the same equipment that George Daniels used to produce his handmade watches. So his legacy actually continues in Roger Smith today. We briefly touched on a few watchmakers and a few watchmaking milestones throughout history. There's many, many more that we could touch on, but with these five individuals and these inventions they had, it changed the course of watchmaking and it changed the course of timekeeping throughout history. And personally, that's what had the biggest effect on me as a watchmaker. I'm Michael Michaels of Watchbox, and this is my take on historical figures in watchmaking.